Where are we? What the hell is going on?
So, quick update, the last few days have been really stressful, very, very stressful. I haven't been in a good place, mentally speaking, at all. Lots of reasons. One, a lot of family drama that I'm not gonna get into, but yeah. Apart from that, my visa has been a huge issue, and it all started because my photograph looked different from my passport photograph, of course, because my passport was created when I turned 18. I'm 21 now. I look pretty different now, even with zero makeup. That started a series of events, requesting extra documents, requesting a lot of other stuff, requesting my psychiatrist approvals, requesting my birth certificate, all kinds of stuff, and it's all being told to us over very fragmented periods of time, because there is no standard protocol for this for an individual traveling with an old passport. And why am I traveling with my old passport? Why haven't I applied for a new one? Because the passport office is yet to implement the NALSA judgment and provide transgender people with new passports before sex reassignment surgery. So the problem is, I'm going abroad to have sex reassignment surgery, and I can't have a new passport before I have the surgery, which means I have to travel with my old passport. I don't really have a choice. And that again is being made difficult by the visa officials. So it's like such a bureaucratic mess, such a mess. And today, we really thought it would be done by today. And my surgery was scheduled for the 6th of February. Today is the 31st of January. Looks like we're going to have to push the surgery date by another week or 2 weeks, just to be safe, because these visa guys are just so unpredictable. And they just keep, you know, returning the passport back, saying, oh, we need extra documents. This is the kind of shit that transgender people in the country have to face just to be ourselves. Just to be ourselves, we have to deal with 1,000 officials who don't know jack shit. As of right now, the visa officials are requesting that my birth certificate be stamped by the Ministry of External Affairs and then sent back to the visa office, and then further processing will happen.
The dust has only just begun to fall, crop circles in the carpet.
So I met my wife. Show them our rings.
Yeah, our rings. See, here.
Yeah. So we exchanged rings and exchanged vows about...
Back in 2016.
When I had just finished my first year. And we had a very romantic time.
Yes, we did.
And her boyfriend was very jealous.
But he's quite generous also, so it's okay.
He's also very generous, yeah. And he's willing to share. Yeah. I'm sure he's going to be okay with.
Yes.
He better be okay with it. He doesn't have a choice.
Yeah.
So we came, we had an impromptu plan of meeting today, and we got drunk and we're very sloshed right now. I needed it, given that my surgery date is going to be postponed for a while. And I really need burbs plus vagene, but it's not happening only. She hasn't met me since I started transitioning.
Yeah. 2 years, no?
Two years. And I'm so glad this happened today. I love you, Priya.
I love you, Trinetra, Halder, Gummaraju.
Yeah. My marks just came out. I passed third year MBBS with first class honours, not distinction, unfortunately, but first class honours, which is still pretty great, given all the crap that's happened this year. I just woke up and I am sober. I've waited 21 years to feel less out of sync with my body, and I've counted the days down for the last 6 months or so. So this in its own way is a little therapeutic, which is, I mean, I get it now. For the longest time, I didn't understand why people documented their lives on video and on YouTube. I thought it was excessive. I thought it was unnecessary, but I get it now.
Sinking, feeling, spin me round again.
I don't know if the visa on arrival thing is going to be an issue or not, if they're going to create issues there. If the airport is going to create issues, if the visa on arrival is going to create issues in Bangkok, I don't know. I really don't know. But we have to give it a shot. We have to try, because rescheduling is just not an option anymore. So I have to travel and just explain to airport officials about the whole situation and just hope for the best, I guess. It's times like these that I really hate, really, really hate being transgender. I hate it. My parents are convinced that the best way to go about traveling to Bangkok tomorrow is for me to dress male, is for me to wear male clothes and take off my piercings and dye my hair and basically look as masculine as possible. Not only, okay, that's profoundly humiliating and profoundly disturbing in my head. There is such a thing as male fail in the transgender community, where you stop looking masculine at a certain point in your transition. Even if you dress relatively male, even if you wear male clothing, you stop looking like a man because your medical transition has progressed far enough to that point of no return, you know, and that's called male fail. And I am well past that point, I think. And even if I tie my hair up, I don't think I will fit into the male queue, and I will only make myself vulnerable and exposed to harassment. And other transgender women have told me in the past that the best way to go about this is just use the female line, dress the way you want. If they question your passport and your documents, explain to them what's happening, and that's that. I don't doubt that my parents want what is best for me. I don't doubt that they want me to be unharmed and for me to have what I want. But in their minds, what is best for me and the path of getting there is not something I agree with. Because their idea of it and the path of getting there, to me, is stressful. It is dysphoria inducing. It is something that compromises on my mental health. It is something that truly doesn't, it is a way of thinking that doesn't truly get me, and I will never agree with that. So for the airport, we are essentially discussing how to make me a boy again, kind of. Like, my womanhood does not reside in jewelry and clothes, but this is just so... In the airport, I can't go through male security again. These fuckers, man, they need to start changing our passports. The passport office needs to fix its shit and, like, change our passports without medical intervention. This is just too much humiliation to handle in one go. Worse has happened, but it's just stupidity, it's stupid shit. Just the thought of going back to being my old self like a year ago is fucking disgusting. Okay, enough is enough. I have decided that I will dress as I am comfortable, but not so different that they can't recognize me in my passport. Definitely not going to dress as male. I will use the female line. Nonetheless, I'm very grateful that dad is coming with me, because I will need somebody. You do need someone. And I'm grateful that dad is doing it, but there's some quirks and kinks to be worked out. Nothing's perfect, right?